James, man, nice to meet you. Dominic, welcome to All Access. First of all, do you mind wearing the bedazzled set?
I thought you'd never ask.
First of all, this incredible score that you got tonight.
Yes.
Are you kidding me right now? And you know what? I've just put Derek. We had all these other guys up here, and we sort of said, look, biggest surprise. And they all said, James, I didn't know this guy could dance.
Neither
especially
did I.
Week one.
Neither did I.
Yeah, this is a surprise for
James, come on. You must have known. You're one of those guys that obviously is on the D floor, and you're really breaking it down. And then you come on the show, and then you're going to kick butt and totally win it.
I mean, I'm an analytical person, so I can, you know, I've got the best teacher, which was helped from the get-go. And for me, it was taking the instructions and applying them, you know, piece by piece, step by step. And the hard part, I think, was kind of getting the flow, getting the emotion out of it a little bit, knowing when to be serious, when to smile, the performance side.
Yeah.
But you did turn that on for the live show. Like, your musicality, when I watch it back now, was even better than we've done in rehearsals.
Yeah, I mean, you're really selling it with your eyes.
Which is
know?
Awesome.
Right?
I
don't even know the fart face.
I don't even know what musicality means.
Can do that.
But apparently I turned it on. So
yes,
there you go.
You did. But actually, our biggest challenge is staying focused.
We laugh a lot.
We go on tangents. We have our code word, Purple Monkey Dishwasher.
Purple Monkey Dishwasher. We just need to know what that means.
It means get back to work.
Yeah, we get back to work.
It's our safe word. It just gets us back to work.
Okay. Well,
you know what I mean.
We need to talk about Hinchtown.
Yes.
Because he is the mayor of
you've
it.
Got your own town.
Yes.
And so I was thinking, like, we were all talking about this. What about Birchburg? Is she the first lady of Hinchtown, or could she be the mayor of Birchburg?
We were thinking Hinchburg.
Hinchburg.
Hinchburg, guys. It's a suburb of Hinchtown. Hinchburg.
At what moment did you realize that you'd made it? Was when you had your own town?
Yeah. Well, here's a key about politics. Here's a little trick for you.
Okay. Come on, guys.
If you want to get
turn the music down.
Right, here we go.
Bring it in close.
If you want to get elected to office, just make up your own town, name it after yourself. Yeah. You're a shoo-in.
So you're the mayor of Hinchtown.
I'm the mayor of Hinchtown.
What do you want to say right now? We've got the political music. Talk to all the people of Hinchtown.
Is this political music?
Oh. Citizens of Hinchtown, I want to tell you. Yeah, this is pretty serious political music. I want to tell you that I have the best partner here in Sharna Burgess, that we are here to try and take that mirror ball trophy. And I'm telling you, I promise you, nobody will work harder than us to make that happen for you.
And then you got to say, I support this message.
My name is James Hinchcliffe, and I endorse this message.
Wow, I think.
There you go.
Career is amazing. I've
been taking some notes off Rick Perry. He's been giving me some pointers.
Rick's been dropping some knowledge on you. Well, let me tell you, right now, there's so much support out here. Look, Caroline right there. She's already obsessed with you guys.
Yay,
thank
Caroline.
Thank you.
We're
appreciate
obsessed
that.
With you.
Yes.
And look, I just want to take you back. That incredible accident that you went through, and now it feels like you've got the zest for life. You just want to go for it right now. How much did that change your mindset and the way you live your life?
Huge, 100%. You know, and the fact that we danced to live life was kind of appropriate. You know,
by Zay Wolf, by the way, who just tweeted us.
Who did? We're very excited to receive a tweet from Zay. Zay, thank you for the incredible song. No, definitely. When you go through something like that, you know, professionally, I didn't change at all. I'm just as driven, just as determined to win, going to take all the same risks that I would. But on a personal side, absolutely. I mean, I don't think I would have done a show like this, you know, 18 months ago. But my eyes are open. I'm living life a different way now. And I can't thank everyone for the opportunity to be here.
And side note, you're wearing a turquoise suit.
I mean, I honestly woke up when I, you know, turned 20 years old and thought that I'm going to make it through the rest of my life without ever wearing a full teal outfit. But, you know, just shows you.
This is week one. I didn't want to tell you what Shana's got planned for week, like, 9. You're going to be
we
like,
we talked about the spandex onesie.
Oh, we got some. But I live in a onesie. I work in a onesie anyway. I'm okay with that.
All right. Well, look, thank you so much for coming up. Incredible job tonight, guys.
Appreciate it.
Thank you to these guys out there for the support. We love you. I support this message. Thanks, James.
Thank you so much.
See you, mate.
Cheers, Tom.
Thanks for coming up. And look, a lot of support. Thank you, Nadia. And the man himself. How are you, brother? Look at you, man. You can go whatever way you want. Yeah, just for once. For once.
One time I'm going to avoid the sparkles.
Now, hello to you two.
You need to suit up.
And first of all, I've got to say, are you crazy? Why were you racing yesterday?
It's my job.
So you were like, you know what? I got to do this.
Yes.
And you did good. You know, you started 20, you ended 12th. That's a good race for you, right?
Yeah, I mean, it was good progress. We didn't start where we wanted to. And the way the race played out, we did what we could, made up a bunch of spots. But, It's all over and done with now. Racing's over, and now I can focus on the dance.
And Sharna, what about you? Were you there? Were you kind of dancing in the pit? What was going on?
I definitely went through the week, and I saw your like practice runs.
Yep.
And actually, James raced me around in the two-seater.
Wow.
Which I thought was going to be terrifying, but it was freaking amazing.
Tell us how quick you were going in that car.
We went, what, 165?
About 165, but at a track like that, it's not the top speed that's impressive. It's the braking and the cornering. Yeah. It's nothing like you've ever experienced.
You have no idea.
Must be having some seriously good like dates with people taking them out.
Not my car. I don't get to use that often.
That would be a special occasion.
That would be awesome. I guess at this point, you're in the pole position, and how are you feeling after last week? I mean, certainly everyone loved you. These guys here have been giving you so much positivity, but does that feel like in some ways there's a target on your back because you are, you know, everyone's saying the early favorite?
We joked about that afterwards. I mean, I think everybody came in, us included, with very tempered expectations, not really knowing what to expect, especially what happens on game day when all the pressure's on. And, you know, obviously she killed it, and, you know,
We killed it.
Team Stop and Go killed it, and it was great.
So Hinchburg never got started?
No, I never
did. Not yet, but hey, listen, hopefully it's a long season and it can get started at some point.
Of course. Right. We have two or three nicknames, right, a season.
Oh, yeah, why not, right?
Why not?
But I think that it is, you know, kind of equally exciting and terrifying to be up there on the top spot, especially going into a week where we had absolutely no prep time and a lot of difficulties in getting this number together, even in the short time we had.
Yes, but come on, Sharna, as well. You must be happy that you've got a guy that can dance. I know we have so many pros up here, and they're like, oh, it's so hard when you've got nothing to work with. Well, you've got someone that really can move.
We're really still discovering what James is great at. Okay, last week we found out Foxtrot and Frame. Amazing. This week I had Latin, I had Paso, completely unknown to James, hadn't started on it, and then all of a sudden I have a day and a half to do it, which I lost half of that time because of song clearances and stuff. So I was terrified, actually. I actually thought this week might be that one where I don't get it together.
Still terrified. We haven't actually shown yet what the result really is, but hopefully it's all right.
But we do have a great dance move for our bumper this time.
Yes. Look, the dress rehearsal literally was amazing. and I think that we've got the fans out there. We've asked them to send in a lot of questions. You guys have got to go. So we're going to quick fire these questions, okay?
Okay.
We want to give these guys a chance to get themselves here. This is from Jane. Yes. They want to know, where were you training before and after? I mean, obviously a busy week for James.
Yeah,
what did you do?
We got some work done here in LA before.
Yeah, we did our work here in LA before, and we got in an hour on Thursday night. But James's schedule this week was insane at the racetrack. So basically no is the answer to your question.
Right.
All right. Thank you, Jane. What does Courtney want to know here? You're dancing to Walking Dead tonight. Who else would make the team from this cast?
Walking Dead inspired.
Inspired, right.
Yes.
Man, who would I want on my zombie apocalypse team? Well, I mean, she would have to be there.
Yeah, Sharna, of course.
Of course.
Come on.
I'd love to hope
you'd have the all-access team as well. I mean, we'd be here. We'd be looking after
all
you.
All of you guys.
We need, I don't know, my brother actually would be great in this situation, I think. He's a pretty switched on guy. Got some good survival instincts.
Good to
survival training, so we'll go with that.
All right, well, look, last question, guys. If James and Sharna went to go-karting, how would you make it fair? I mean, what would you do? What are you prepared to do?
That's a little much. That's a little dangerous. I would give her a lap head start.
Wow.
And I'd have to chase her down.
Well,
they're only like five minutes.
Unbelievably unfair.
Now, have you ever done that? James gone on a date or something and taken someone, given them like a huge head start, and then... You know?
No, I just try and win all the time. I can't do it. It's not in my nature. It's awful. It's terrible.
Don't let the sweetness fool you. This guy is competitive.
Well, I tell you, you're in the right place because this is a competition. Tomorrow,
absolutely,
of course, the first elimination. We're not even talking about that. We hope that you're going to be fine. Of course, you can vote up to 12 times each person.
Please vote.
The fans are all sitting out there right now with their phones, and they are voting. This is your team name.
Yeah.
There we go.
Stop and go. There you go. Hold it up.
I love that.
We even have the
look at this guy. Unbelievable.
The traffic light and everything. I love it.
I love it.
Well, look, thanks for coming up, guys.
Of course.
I think you guys are going to do great.
Thank you.
And we appreciate you coming up, and so do these guys as well.
Thanks so much, guys.
Let's give them a big round of applause.
Thank you, guys.
James. Always a pleasure.
Yeah.
See you soon.
Bye,
see you, Sharna. And look out for something very special from these guys a little later on in the show. We know how crazy this is. Come on, we've got some Cirque performers in here. We've got this man, James, coming in. Good to see you, brother. I'm a clown. Okay, here we go. Look, how are you doing? Now, look, this is a bit of a party tonight.
This is going to be...
Oh, my gosh. Can we get that down like that?
we're gonna. Well, what about if you just hold it underneath like that?
Hang on, squeeze it in.
You kind of hear me, and then you go like this.
In for a sec because I was checking tweets, and now I'm done.
Yeah, okay. Look at this, guys.
This is problem solving 101.
First of all, you guys look fabulous. Sharna, someone told me you had a problem with clowns. How are you feeling right now?
Do you want to switch spots?
No, I'm good.
What is it about clowns that you have a major problem with?
I mean, just don't like
Kiwi
them.
Clowns or just in general clowns?
Just
or
in general. Okay, so the truth is when I was a kid, I had this teddy bear in my room that was this massive clown. And then my cousins who were older than me watched It. And there began my fear of clowns. I started having dreams where he was coming to life to eat me. And so I don't like clowns anymore.
You insist you're not feeling it? Well, look, Emma was supposed to be a clown as well, but she didn't get the memo, right?
No, I did get the memo. I put a lot of effort into my costume.
Well, look at this.
Oh, no, this is James embarrassing. We
along.
Came as the same
Unbelievable.
Thing.
Unbelievable.
I hate all of you right now.
Look, there's
all
one there
them.
For you. Look, Sharna, can you see it there? Look. No, we won't make you dress up as
it. It's more like Rudolph. What if I just go for the reindeer?
The only way to overcome
it's Red Nose Day.
Look at that.
It's Red Nose Day.
Well, very soon we're going to cross to the live show, which is going to swing there, and we're going to laugh. Like, I'm not even having this conversation with you. And we're going to wave, and it's going to be, like, so
terrified.
Animated.
You can laugh.
I think
I'll
what we
terrified.
Should do is we all fake laugh as the camera. Like, we've just cracked the most amazing
we
joke.
We call that
okay?
the JCPenney.
The JCP? Okay.
The JCPenney.
So I'm going to be the one that sort of says it, and you guys laugh like I've just cracked you up, okay?
Okay.
The JCP, all right? We're coming
so
soon. Yeah, exactly, Sharna. You've nailed it.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're coming to you guys soon. What I want to talk about before we do that is Cirque du Soleil in general.
Yeah.
Fans?
Huge fans, yeah. Absolutely.
Oh, massive
yeah.
fan. This week was incredible. It was a dream to be able to, you know, be a part of that. And I love watching every performance tonight.
Well, you guys getting ready to fake laugh, right?
Yes, we are.
Because
James,
here we go.
I can't see that
are you involved creatively in your costumes?
I do what I'm told, Emma.
Really? Are you a kept circus man?
I literally just show up, I put on what's in front of me, she decides if she likes it or not, and that's how this happens.
Oh, very
I'm
nice.
I'm a
well,
slight bit
good.
Of a control freak.
Are we all? Me too.
There we go, guys. Look, unbelievable. Oh, no. There we go. No.
We missed
see.
It?
Yes. Unbelievable. We missed it. I don't know what happened, but...
Oh, I tried to give you. I was like, he's so. Oh, it's not happening.
Unbelievable.
Oh, God, it is not
well,
happening.
Emma, you go and find out what
okay,
happened.
I
answer
will.
Some questions. And let's talk Paramore quickly, because you went and saw the show.
We did. We flew
in the how much does that add into it? Like, how much value does that add to be able to see the thing that you got to do? Because you've still got to make it about a dance thing. And how do you bring the right amount of circuit, I guess, is what I'm asking.
You know, the truth is, this week I got so excited about having all these Cirque elements that at some point I was like, okay, but remember, it's not about making a Cirque production. It's about collaborating, and it's about James. And I feel like we found the right and the perfect balance for this. But truly, what makes it come to life is the fact that James can take on the character of AJ, and that's because he went to see Paramore, which was such an amazing production. And he really today is embodying that, you know, the greatest director in the whole damn biz.
I don't know if you knew that. But I am, in fact, the greatest director in Hollywood.
I did not. Now I know.
I had a couple bad shows.
Yeah.
This next one with my star Indigo
Unbelievable.
Is going to be bananas.
Because
I am Indigo.
And what? So what is it? What has changed this week? You're just like, let's do this, because you seem to be enjoying it so much, and you seem to be getting better, and it seems to be more fun for you as an experience week on week out.
You get more comfortable for sure. You get into you get a little bit of understanding of what happens throughout the week and how it all comes together. You know, last week was kind of a big learning experience for me, having everything completely fall off the rails in dress rehearsal and having to bring it all back in time for the performance a couple hours later. So that's all part of it. As you go through it, you learn more, you enjoy it more, you become more comfortable. I know I've said it time and time again since day one, I've got the best coach, the best teacher to help me get through all these different things that we're experiencing. So it's been fun.
Well, you know what we're going to do right now? We're going to test your performance, okay? Because,
oh,
of course,
no.
You are playing kind of a Hollywood poet, right? That goes to Hollywood and just deciding whether or not it's going to work for him. So we thought we've got a poetry opportunity for you both right now, okay? So can we have some poetry music? There's the poetry music. Can you hear it?
Okay. I'll tune into the
poetry
music.
Okay. What's poetry?
This is like a beatnik poetry.
Okay.
And all you need to do, James, is just deliver this as best you can. And we'll give some finger snap. Can we have some finger claps?
Everybody snap. Everybody snap. Here we go.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay,
turning,
go, baby. Come on.
And turning, ever whirling. The speed increases, the checkered flag unfurling. Car engine screams. It's getting bossy. But that's no car. It's a red-headed Aussie.
I'm not a dancer, but that point is moot. She says g'day, and I say a boot.
Very good.
Another night in the ballroom, erasing some frowns. That's a day in the life for the mayor of Hinchtown.
Unbelievable. Can we get the clicks?
I can.
Incredible. Now, I'm going to put some major pressure on you, Sharna. You're next.
Ah, yes.
Roses are red, violets are blue. Poisonous spiders are usually brown with black markings. Seriously, guys, watch yourself in Australia. I was like,
incredible. That's amazing. That is really good.
There is no country that has more things that are trying to kill you than Australia.
It's very true.
Sharks, crocodiles, snakes, spiders.
We're trying to keep people out.
Apparently.
That's why she's here, man.
That's why she left.
New Zealand's the place to be. But anyway, that's another story.
But anyway.
I'm going to get out of the middle of this one.
We, of course, want to thank all of you guys for sending in your questions, and we're going to have a few of them right now.
Perfect.
Guys, we've got any fan questions? No. It's all happening there. Okay, no. Well, I want to ask you.
Hit me.
At this point of the competition, knowing that tomorrow is a double elimination, does it factor into it, or you just kind of push it away? And what Sharna said to you, what was Sharna's first thing that she said to you when you found out as well?
I mean, we only found out when everyone else did. We were standing on stage during the opening and found out. So
I booed, so that pretty much tells you how I feel about
it. Yeah, we both kind of did the booing thing. But at the end of the day, it can't affect anything. We came into this wanting to give it our all, wanting to do the best that we possibly could do, and that's what we're going to do. No matter if one couple is going home, two couples, three couples, doesn't matter.
Yeah.
All we can control is us.
Right.
And so we're going to go out there, lay it all on the line, put out the best performance we can, and hopefully it's enough for the fans to vote.
That's it, guys. You heard what they said. Voting is the trick here.
Absolutely.
Well, look, thank you guys for coming up. Have we got that question? We do have some questions, so we'll just take one before you go.
Here we go. Well, look.
What does this mean?
So,
what is this? Come on, give us some insight here, or can we? Can we talk
about
it?
You explain who Sophia is, and I'll explain how often she comes out.
Well, Sophia is like the fiery version of Sharna that demands greatness, basically.
Yes,
and we discovered her name last week because it was Ricardo.
Right, it was she's always been known as Sharna number two was kind of the name. But last week when Ricardo showed up, Sophia was his partner. And so now we know that Sophia is the fiery one that comes
She's
out.
In there.
As she said, demands greatness.
One day I want to meet Sophia up here.
Just come to any of our rehearsals because she's always at every minute of every rehearsal.
She always shows up without fail. She's dedicated.
That's one word for it.
Well, guys, thank
you. Well, tonight I'm Jessica Rabbit, though. I mean, clearly.
That's true.
You look fabulous. Incredible. I mean, I wish I could have, you know. Actually, I don't think I do.
You've got the rhinestones, though.
I think you're good. We could do with less of the clown face.
Yes.
You're good.
Okay. Well, let's give them some finger claps. And thank you so much for coming in, guys.
Thanks. Always a pleasure.
And look, have a great dance. You guys are going to do great.
Thank
Cheers.
You.
Thanks so much.
James.
Cheers. Mwah.
And there they go. Looking fabulous and getting ready for what's going to be an incredible, incredible night for them. I can feel it. He's already in character. Not only have we got James, Connor Daly is here. Wow. James Rogue, good to see you. And Connor, Dominic, man, welcome to All Access. You're going to have to go bedazzled, you okay? Connor,
you know,
look at this.
More and more bedazzled every week. And
Connor, I'm going to go straight to you, Connor, on this one. Look,
gold's
you
my
see
color.
Your boy here, and he's bedazzled up the wazoo. I mean, did you ever think you'd see him dressed like this?
Again.
Honestly, no.
Again.
Like, this whole deal has been really weird. Like, each week is getting weirder.
Like, just so we can clarify.
I don't get it.
Good weird, bad weird?
Yeah. Like, it's like, good job, James. You're a different human now? I don't get it. It was really cool, I guess.
Are you looking forward to him potentially bedazzling his car on the inside or the steering wheel?
Yes,
James,
absolutely.
I'm going to bedazzle some of his clothes.
Okay.
Connor and I are roommates, actually. Yeah. So I'm going to sneak into his closet and chuck a couple rhinestones on there.
Little did you know, while you've been gone, I've been in your house.
Well, Connor, wasn't there a situation when James was out, you were driving for him or in his position? So, I mean, I got to ask the question. If something happens to him this week, I mean, are you going to jump in and step in there? You get to dance with Sharna.
Yes.
You get to dance with Sharna.
Absolutely, then. I'm in. Yeah. Count me in. She's a lovely lady.
Okay,
yeah.
Look, let's play some music and let's see Connor dance right now.
Go.
Wow, unbelievable. That's a 10 from me. What about you, James?
Mine was the Macarena.
Yeah, sorry. Come on. That was just natural.
There's no way that we can believe that you weren't a dancer before the show. What I mean is something drops on in the D floor and you're at the club. You had some moves, bro.
I have a character witness to show
that. We literally
spent
a lot of time at the club and I have
doing nothing. Related to dancing.
So you were just like at the back, like just doing the side to side?
Yeah, absolutely.
The foot tapping circle and stuff like that.
You know that scene in the movie Hitch where Will Smith's explaining to Kevin James, like, this is it. This is your happy place. Yep. Arms at 90, back and forth. This is where you live. This is home.
Well, then, try and explain it to us then. How come he's so good? What the heck?
Guys, unless he's drinking a lot of alcohol backstage, I don't know. I mean,
he's pretty.
Don't ask those sort of questions on camera, Connor.
What are you thinking?
Sorry.
Now, of course, today is Canadian Thanksgiving?
Yeah.
Well, look, we're getting people sending in us.
That's right. Thank you.
These guys were telling us. I mean, how is it? I mean, it must be emotional right now to be able to dance on this one, James.
And it's tough.
What is the food situation for Canadian Thanksgiving?
Traditional poutine or what? I mean, it's actually just kind of like American Thanksgiving. We just have it in October instead of November.
Wow.
If I'm honest, man, it's not a whole lot different.
So you're gonna leave here and you're gonna what are you trying to jump the gun on us? I mean, what's the game plan there?
No, we did it last night actually. My girlfriend Becky, Sharna, and I, we went out and got some dinner and we got some turkey and some sweet potatoes and some mac and cheese.
Connor didn't get the invite.
Thanks for the invite.
Thanksgiving.
Yeah, wow,
unbelievable.
Connor was busy. He had to drive a race car today.
I did.
Connor, when you look at something like this and you think about racing, you know what James has been through and you know what tonight's about.
Yeah.
It's not about the crash. It's about the recovery and it's about what happens next.
For sure.
You were there and you went through that with him. Tell us what that was like for you as a buddy.
Honestly, I mean, it was inspiring, like, because I saw him from, like, day one of, well, we were in the hospital when the guy had freaking stuff in his chest so he couldn't talk. He could only write with us. So, you know, we saw it all. We were there, and, you know, I had to fill in for him, which, you know, felt weird because, you know, he's been trying to help me get a ride. And then he took
it
really literally.
It was very selfless of me to just try and kill myself and give him a seat.
Like, I didn't know it would be that extensive.
It's shake and bake, isn't it? He drives behind and then he comes forward.
Yeah.
It's the vibe.
So, yeah, I mean, it was, like, it was really, really cool to see because the guy was, like, getting on his bicycle before he was allowed to get on his bicycle to try and start training to get back fit again. And it was really, really incredible because I also went out with him. I rode his girlfriend's bike that didn't work. And, but I was out there and I was trying to, you know, go with him because it was really cool and pretty inspiring to see that, like, he just – nothing was going to stop him getting back into the car. So it was really cool.
And look at your boy now, right?
Yeah.
He's out there bedazzling up the storm.
He's a star.
Just foxtrotting. And I think
he's going to give the race thing up and he's going to be on Broadway. What do you think?
Oh, well, then, okay, because I can drive his car. Then again, that'll be fine.
I'll do it.
Spirit fingers. All right, well, we're going to let you guys go. Thank you so much for coming up, man. What a pleasure to meet you, bro.
Thank you.
And always a pleasure to see you, brother.
Great to meet you, James.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I appreciate that. An emotional
nice
guy.
Yeah, great stuff out there on the floor.
Yeah.
Thanks for everything, guys. Lots
to learn.
Love it.
All right. Thank you, guys. Thanks for coming up, Connor.
Thank you.
And give our love to Sharna, wherever she may be right now. Connor, if something happens, you're the boy. You're going to step in. All right, so there it is. Yes, play them out. Play them out. The All Access Orchestra. We've got to thank this man right here for just absolutely crushing it. Yes, I know what you're thinking.
Well, hello.
Twinsies, right? Am I wrong with the twinsies?
I love your style.
Thank you. That was actually good of you. This is actually Val's shirt from last week.
See, that was actually what inspired this one.
Well, I tell you what.
Tell me.
Congratulations, you two.
Thank
on
you.
On what was an incredible dance.
Well, thank you so
and
much.
And let me tell you, these guys here went absolutely crazy for it.
Wonderful.
It was a technical dance, and you absolutely nailed it. Were you Ricardo out there? Were you James out there? Drop it on us.
This one was James. The boss didn't want Ricardo this week. She wanted James, and so that's who showed up.
Shane, that's a rad way to look at it. You were just like, dude, you don't need Ricardo.
No, he was killing it. And Ricardo came in when we needed him. You know, it was, okay, it's Monday, and James is not killing it. And it was like 3-4 weeks ago now.
It was a while ago.
You've grown so much since then. We don't need Ricardo. Go away, Ricardo.
How are you going to bring this newfound sexiness into your real job, the other job? Are you going to be like giving it the, when you're seeing the other drivers, like giving them a Zoolander?
What's up?
Oh, how are you doing?
I'm about to beat you, dude.
The thing is, the
hey, guys, look, it was a joke. Look at this. The sexiness.
The reason that we, the reason I struggled so much with the sexiness.
When is it on?
Is oh. I
Where's your red light?
I know, there's no red light.
Sorry, James.
It's always awkward when that happens, but I want to hear. Let's get back to you being sexy. Come on.
This is why I struggled being sexy, because in my job, I wear a helmet.
Yeah.
No one sees my face.
But the thing is,
no matter how I'm feeling.
What I don't understand, Sharna, is that when you're talking about probably one of the most professional sexiness jobs out there is a race car driver.
It's very sexy.
Every girl, when she's young, she wants to date a rock star, a race car driver. The host of All Access.
Those are the three things, right?
No?
See, there's this whole thing we like think that you're all bad boys.
Yes.
But as a grown woman, you don't really want the bad boy. You want the guy that appears to be a bad boy, but he's really a good guy on the inside.
So how did you bring how did you bring that sexiness out of him this week?
Listen, it's all James. You know, we talked about, you know, he's not the rip your shirt off and feel up your body kind of sexy. He's more classy than that. And so we decided to create sexiness through chemistry. And I feel like we had a great chemistry through that dance. And we literally spent so many hours staring at each other.
True.
Right? Nose to nose and just like getting comfortable with that so we could create that kind of a vibe. And I feel like we really had it.
Okay, I agree.
Just look at each other just quick now for 10 seconds in silence. Let's awkward it up.
Oh, no. See, now... Oh.
This is amazing, guys. This is an All Access exclusive, guys. This is happening live right now. Can we get the exclusive noise? It's amazing. This is really happening, guys. And fantastic. That was amazing. Now, look, what we've noticed about you, James, is you really work so hard to get it right. So you're a perfectionist. Then you've got Sharna, who's also a perfectionist,
yes.
Right? So we've got this ongoing series that we're going to do on the show, okay? Up here at All Access, which we like to call...
James versus Sharna, pole position.
That's right, pole position, baby. That took 17 animators 3 months to make. So I want to give a shout out to them right now. Now, quickly, pole position, what is that? That's kind of like when you get a bit of a head start, right?
That's when you qualify first.
Yeah.
So, like, you qualifying for the start of the race, that means you get to start first.
Okay, cool. Well, you're probably wondering, like, what am I going to win? Am I going to win a Mirrorball? No. You're going to win the All Access Milk. Because, you know, if you're a driver in Indy, you get to drink
Indy
the milk.
Indy 500, you get to
this
drink the milk.
This is it. We're going to refrigerate it for you. One of you guys is going to win some milk.
That's the best trophy in sports right there.
Yeah. So look, so that's the All Access Milk too, so it's very special.
I like it.
All you guys need to do, because this week is Spanish infused, all right?
Right.
So we're going to kick this one off with the Bolero, okay? It's the first person who throws it up, gets it on, they win. And they
cup and ball.
Will get the cup and balls, baby. I know. Cup and ball. She's like, what are we talking about?
Easy.
And
this is tough.
You will get pole position for next week. Let me tell you, next week's challenge is going to be tough. All right, let's hit the music, and it's time to play. Let's play, guys.
I keep overshooting.
Oh, he's already done it. Unbelievable. Guys, that was a game of... Look at
that. That was not even a game. How was that a game?
Was I supposed to
guys,
let you win?
Guys, you've just played
pole position.
James B. Sharna, man. I've got some great news. You are now, you have the pole position. You got a great score tonight. Look, Shana's not happy about it.
She's also very competitive. That's what's bad.
That's it.
Well, that's why we're a good team, because we get the same scores.
I can feel that it's going to be like one that Shana's going to nail it.
Okay.
But anyway, we've got some fan questions. Congratulations on what was a great dance, some great scores, and a lot of love from these people out here. So let's get to them. Great question, Melissa. What is the speed limit in Hinchtown?
In Hinchtown, everybody knows when it's appropriate to go a bit quicker.
I would have thought it'd be
when
like
it's not, so we really don't have them.
Not, so I thought it would be like an autobahn sort of German thing where you just there is
it's
no speed limit.
It's kind of your own deal. You just got to play nice with others and you can do whatever you want.
Okay, man, Hinchtown, want to go there? Let's go there. What? One more. Come on, here we do. What additional work did you need to do to teach a non-dancer like James compared to one who could dance like Charlie?
I mean, it's completely different. Here we go. Couldn't even hear myself on that one. It's completely different. Everyone is different, actually. Teaching James, he understands physics. He's very logical. So teaching James is very different to teaching Charlie. Charlie had dance background. And he had a lot of ballet training, actually, because of what he does on the ice. And so he understood dance talk. Whereas James more understands momentum and physics and the breakdown, the mathematics of the movement.
And she always comes up with racing terms. An analogy to help me out.
Can you got an example? What do we got?
So, like, she references shock absorbers a lot, you know, which is your legs and ankles and knees. Yeah. We talked, you know,
centrifugal force
comes up a lot. hairpins is actually a dance
turns.
Move. We have hairpin turns in racing.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So that happens a lot.
That's good work,
Sharna. How do you brake? You have to slow down before you stop your stop point?
Yeah, slow down before you stop.
So it's the same principle.
It feels like it's working, right?
The KERS system.
The KERS
system. It was a little bit more complicated.
You're liking that,
minute
though,
to
right?
learn how to say that. I was like, the KERS? And waves?
Were you Googling that, Sharna?
The KERS.
Were you Googling that, Sharna, so you knew the terms?
I don't know how to spell it to Google it.
All right, let's do one more question, and then you guys can get out of here. It sounded nuts. Is there a chance that he's actually Wolverine and that you have mutant healing powers?
Yeah, that's really funny. I was going to try and do Wolverine for Halloween, but we got a better one.
We did get a good one for Halloween. I'm excited about that. Yes. I was trying to find him a way.
I wasn't
supposed to say anything.
He's secretly Wolverine.
I am, in fact, Wolverine.
All right, and last question before you go.
What other sports do I follow besides racing? How about baseball? Blue Jays playing right now. We have the boys in blue to take home the win today over Cleveland. Come on, guys.
I follow football. I'm following the Steelers. I'm still a Steelers girl from Dancing with Antonio last season. Hopefully, I'm going to go out and see their away game on Thanksgiving. And, hopefully we'll go to the Super Bowl, right?
That's it, man. Well, look, hopefully we'll go to the Mirror Ball. How about that?
Sounds good.
All right. Thank you guys so much for coming up. Great job.
Cheers.
Make sure you vote, all right?
Please vote.
You want to see some more? I want to see what you got planned for Halloween. Can you give us even a little taste?
No.
No.
It's too good.
Not even a hint.
It's too good.
It's so good.
Yeah.
Oh, it's so good.
Okay. Well, you need to vote then, because we all need to see that, okay?
Yes. Team dance next week.
And who wore it better? I think we know the answer to that. Look at this. This guy. He nailed it. Unbelievable.
He's got the rhinestones.
Yes. Forget it. All right, so congratulations for a great dance. We're going to get James in here, Max.
Yo.
And you hang around.
Sorry about that.
Get on in here, brother. Look at this. That's it, man. It's a regular old family here.
I'm the only guy who goes for the guy things, right? This guy's sparkle. You know, there's
a bedazzled one here, look. You could, James will happily wear bedazzled.
Only appropriate given what I'm wearing.
You look amazing.
You know what's funny is this shirt started just green.
Yeah, and you were like, I need to bedazzle it up or I'm not wearing it.
And then after wardrobe and for dress rehearsal, it got a little bedazzled. And then after dress rehearsal and before tonight, it got even more bedazzled. It's just, by the end of the show, I'm just going to be one giant rhinestone.
Are you going to take that into your real world life as well? You know, just buy some clothes and then just get it home and just bedazzle the hell out of it?
You mean more than I am currently?
Yeah, more.
Yes,
more.
Definitely.
To
more.
The next level.
Yes, I will be going full Dancing with
the
Stars.
Well, look, we've got to ask. I mean, we're about to wave to the main show, but we've got to ask about the workload this week and how you've handled that.
Yes.
And what Sharna has done to help you handle that.
This week was tough for sure with two dances. Having to get the group dance down on top of the individual dance is a lot of extra work. Honestly, it's a lot more work for the pros, too. That entire first rehearsal was really the pros choreographing everything, planning it all out. Calvin, Marine, Ryan, and I really just got to kind of get to know each other better, if I'm honest. So, they have so much work just preparing a single routine. I have to do two, especially in a group, all the different elements.
We watched the dress rehearsal. How hard or easy was that to kind of work with people that you hadn't worked with before who are also not pros, if you know what I mean?
Yeah, what's so great is we have a really good group on Team Pass. I'm not just saying that. All the pros really get along. They really work in the same kind of fashion. They work well together. So as the routine came together, there was no arguments. There was no power struggles. There was nothing like that. And then once we hit the dance floor, you know, Maureen had the benefit of having three female pros to kind of polish her. And then, you know, with Artem, he had three athletes who are used to coaching. And so we leaned on each other. We leaned on him. And the work dynamic was actually great.
Yeah, well, it certainly looked like you guys were really enjoying it. And I think at this stage of the competition with two dancers, people are voting for what you do out there.
Right.
I mean, you have your fan bases in those first weeks. But right now, it's like if someone just kicks it out, you know, just nails it, people are going to pick up the phone and vote. How much pressure is that, knowing that at this point there's so many fantastic dancers? You've got to kind of lift the game each week on week. But let's give us a wave first over here. Look, we've got James, we've got Max, we've got the whole family, man. It's happening up here. Look at this guy. We're over here. Look, unbelievable. We're just keeping it real. And, you know what I mean? Like, at this point, I think we've got so many talented performers. And you're right from the start, you've been fantastic. In some ways, these guys are kind of caught up.
No, 100%. I mean, everybody gets better every single week. And so you know you've got to push yourself a little further. And Sharna and I knew that for this week. Our jitterbug, it's got some moves in it that I don't think we'd be trying in week two.
Yeah.
But we're in week seven. You know, you got to push. You got to make sure that that you're giving it all. Because like you say, there's a lot of good dancers in this competition.
I know that, you know, and I've seen some of the footage of the move that you're going to attempt with the head underneath. Was that Sharna? Because to me, watching you do it, even in the early rehearsals, it was like, wow, this is, if this goes wrong, it kind of goes wrong, right?
Yeah, no, that was very much my feeling, too. She showed me a clip of one of the moves, and I'm like, oh, that was cool. She's like, no, we're going to try this one. I'm like, no, what's the one we're going to try, though? You know, and it was like this huge mental barrier I had to come across. Well, literally,
from day one of rehearsal, how long did it take to actually get it right once?
It was day two before we nailed it, and it almost took an entire rehearsal for me to get the guts to actually run at her and try it. But she's a champ, she's a star, and she, you know, had faith in me to pull it off, which was putting a lot of her safety in my hands.
Well, look, I mean, the dress, you absolutely nailed it, and I know that when you come onto the stage, you know, do you feed off that crowd? I mean, it really feels like from your dress to your dance performances, it lifts. And is that something that you actually are conscious of? Or?
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, that was the biggest surprise for me in week one. You know, you go through camera blocking, you go through dress rehearsal, you've done the routine on the floor with the cameras and everything else. The only thing you don't see until show night is the audience. And I'll never forget the very beginning of our foxtrot, we have a little twirl kind of moment there, and the crowd just blew up. And I was like, I was not ready for that noise, you know, yeah. But it really does lift you. And now week to week, you just kind of enjoy that element of it so much
more. Because
you're
not really, in the car, you wouldn't exactly get that, right? I mean, you can see them, but you're like focused.
It's not like, you know, Calvin, he hears, you know, he would have heard all the fans in a stadium when he was playing.
It's kind of addictive, right? I'm imagining.
It's not like that in racing. So this is a very new experience for me.
Well, man,
really
you're killing it out there. And these guys here are loving it. I know Sharna, where is she right now? She's downstairs getting her hair fruit or
getting everything sorted. Yeah. She had a little.
Is she going to be matching
in dress rehearsal,
the military as well? She's going to be.
She is. She's in a very similar color dress.
Because we have heard something about a knee. Like, can you tell us more? What do we know?
So in dress rehearsal during the team number, Sharna's dress was a little bit too long, and she actually caught it with her foot and slipped, fell. I fell with her, and she banged her knee up pretty good. But she's been working with the doctors here on staff, and everything feels pretty good so far. I mean, and she's a champ. I mean, she's not going to let a little bump on the knee hold her back.
You just bash her as a solo? What do you think?
I don't think that's a great idea.
No, look, for the injuries that we have seen Sharna have through the seasons, I mean, literally, I don't know what you'd have to do to get her off that dance floor. We've got a couple of fan questions.
Sure.
These guys here have been going crazy. Of course, they want to send their love to Sharna, so make sure that you pass it on when you go down, that everyone up here, you know, just can't wait to see what you guys have got planned.
For sure.
Let's take a few questions.
Is there a significance to the necklace I wear? There is, actually. Yeah, I'll try and give you the abbreviated version of the story, but the necklace was given to me by a young girl, Stephanie, who was a Make-A-Wish kid. She's been in hospital basically since she was born, and at the hospital she goes to, you get what's called a bravery bead every time you have an appointment or a checkup or a surgery or anything like that. And Stephanie, at 12 years old, had 1,600 bravery beads. And
wow.
I had attended an event for Make-A-Wish when I was still kind of going through my recovery after my accident last year, and she thought it was so brave of me to come visit her and her friends when I still wasn't feeling well, and she wanted to give me one of her bravery beads. And I told her I wouldn't take it off until I got back into a race car. And that day came and went, and I thought, I'm not ready to take it off. So I said, I'm going to keep it on now until I get back into a race again. And that day came and went, and I decided I wasn't ready to take it off. And I've worn this necklace every day since she's given it to me, and I don't think I'll ever take it off.
And I'm sure it's helping you with the bravery of getting out there, right?
It's one of those things.
It puts things in perspective, doesn't it?
It really does, man. You see that thing hanging in the mirror, and you think, this is fine. This is easy.
But just to quickly ask that question, I mean, 6 months ago, you've done so well on the show, even till now, and there's a long way to go. I mean, are you proud of what you've achieved? And when you think about things like that, I mean, it must make the journey, but also when you're going to look back on this in 5-10 years and go, whoa, what a trip, man.
I mean, it's one of those things where, you know, and I've talked about it before, I wouldn't have done something like this probably before the accident and before things like this to make you realize what really is important and to take advantage of opportunities in life, you know. And I'm super proud of what we've accomplished so far in this show. I'm hoping we can keep it going a little while longer, but I'll look back on this experience with just nothing but smiles.
Well, man, we're loving you up here. Can we get a couple more questions and then we're going to let you go?
Sure.
All right.
Oh, yes, we saw a lot of cool costumes. That was quite an event. We obviously went repping Top Gun.
Represent.
Yes. So that was it was tough wearing shades in a dark club, though.
Yeah, look, you see people do it all the time. It's not as easy, right?
Yeah, but honestly, one of the best costumes was actually Troop Dancer Alan. He was there as the Joker, and he had some. He looked the part.
You got some ideas for Halloween? I mean, what are you going to drop there? I mean, you've got the wardrobe to raid. You could just get anything done.
It's one of the most exciting things. I mean, we you know, providing we make it through tonight, next week is Halloween. We get to perform on Monday on
Sharna
Halloween.
Sharna kind of gave us, she didn't give us much, but she gave us a tease if it was going to be pretty special. Can you tell us anything?
I can't. I'm sworn to secrecy, but I'm super excited about it. And I already told her that as soon as the show's done, as soon as we're off air, I'm just bolting for the door. I'm not going to let wardrobe come anywhere near me. I'm not going to talk to anybody.
Look,
I'm going to run out of the room
on.
With all the stuff.
I've got to make a plea to the fans out there. If you guys want to see that, you got to vote. James, thanks so much for coming up. And look, send our love to Sharna.
I will.
You've got two dancers tonight. You're going to kill both of them. We really appreciate you coming up.
Thank you so much.
And you look sharp as always, baby.
Trying. Thank you so much,
guys.
I'm
not sure what era I'm in, but I'm doing my best.
Well, I'm going to start bringing this look back. I like that.
Hey, she.
Put up your dukes and fight like a man, she.
Thank you, James. Give our best to Sharna. And it's my boy. Look at you. Look at me, look at you, we all look fabulous. I've got these guys to thank. They voted and they made me a zombie cheerleader. So
on a dead or dying or murdered, what kind of cheerleader are
you? Well, I think I would have been kind of like, you know, a little sassy sort of little cheerleader, and then boom, I'm done and now I'm a zombie. But it's not about me, James, it's about you. And there's a lot going on in your week this week. First
yes.
of all,
Busy
the
week.
Fact that you lost the beard. Now, I was just talking to Sharna about this.
Yeah.
We've managed to track down.
This is actually
James's beard.
I kept it. I left it in the sink in my trailer.
How many years has it been?
So I've only had it clean shaven once in the last decade, and that was back in 2012.
Wow.
So it's been four years.
You look fabulous.
What has the beautiful makeup team here, Dancing with the Stars, made me look like
How quick do you grow it? Are we going to have a beard by next week?
Yeah, we'll be good by next week.
Okay, good.
Luckily, it comes back pretty quick.
Well, look, to one of our All Access super fans, you can win James's beard.
Yes.
All you've got to do is at DWTS All Access and tell us why you think you deserve James's beard.
Right.
And James is going to sign it.
I'm
going to
sign the bag.
He's going to sign the beard.
Spray some of my cologne in there.
Huge. It's going to be amazing. It's an incredible opportunity, guys.
Absolutely.
So
once in a
lifetime. Congratulations.
Because I'll never do this again.
Now, we must talk about the big, big news for you, and that's Sharna. We just had an interview with her, and I said, look, what are the chances you're going to be back on the ballroom floor? She said 100% I will be back. But tell us about the devastation for you as a celeb who's doing so well and has to kind of get the world turned upside down, because you want to be there for Sharna as a friend, but you also want to compete in the comp, you know?
And that's just it. I mean, for me, the devastation was as a friend, you know, to see someone get hurt and be in pain and not get to do what they love to do. That was the toughest part. You know, for me, then having to, you know, lose my... Look, I've only danced with one person my entire dancing career. All 2.5 months of it has been with one partner. And so, you know, it's almost like switching teams in sports, or, you know, switching engineers in racing would kind of be, you know, a similar sort of analogy there. And there is a kind of get-to-know-you phase. There is a period where you have to learn how each other works.
In some ways, I feel for Jenna as well, you know, to 100%. Kind of come in, and she's like, oh, I want to make sure I do Sharna's vision. Just do it right and do it justice.
Exactly right. And especially this week. I mean, Sharna and I have been talking about Halloween week.
We were saying,
since
you keep
week
coming
one.
Up here and talking to us, going, I'm not going to reveal anything, but just get us to Halloween.
She was so excited about this one. And it's still creatively hers. I mean, it was her vision. It's her choreography. This is very much a Sharna Burgess production, just performed by Jen and James.
Well, look, man, Halloween, it's a fun time of year. Are you a prankster? I mean, we would imagine that you would be in that way. I mean, what's your Halloween vibe normally?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm a big fan of Halloween. It's always a fun night. The most stressful part about Halloween is just coming up with a good enough costume. I don't like half-assing things, you know, and... This get-up turned out very well. I'm super...
Well, look, we're hearing from Periscope, Facebook Live out there. They're thinking you look hot right now.
This, I might actually keep the green hair and the dark eyes for a while.
I think it works, man.
This is actually my natural skin tone. I'm naturally this pale, so that's easy.
Yeah, well, you got to get a spray tan, man. I think they do someone around here get some spray
tans.
They
made me do that in week six. And
you were like,
that was,
never again?
That was it.
Are you saying no to the spray tans?
No
James,
spray
James
tans.
James is done with it.
Can't
well, look,
do it.
We're always trying to make more money up here at All Access.
Yeah,
okay?
Of course.
So what we've done is
I'm weirded out you didn't sell the beard hair.
Well,
just give
no, because we knew we had this thing up our sleeve.
All right.
we're going to get all of our celebs tonight to pitch their Halloween candy bar, okay? And we've come up with this one here. Yeah. Cue the music. It's called the Hinchcliffe Bar.
Right.
Okay.
The Hinchcliffe Bar.
Tell us why we should purchase
this.
Well,
it's very nutritious, obviously. It's great for you. High in protein.
Yeah.
It's GMO-free, gluten-free, sugar-free, USDA organic.
Yeah.
I mean, it tastes like candy, but it's so good for you.
When your stomach is rumbling like a race engine, it's the perfect thing, isn't it?
And you want to hit the dance floor, and you need that energy, that quick fix.
And I hear it's got Canadian maple in it.
Hinchcliffe Bar is your answer.
That's
it's got it, some man. It's maple flavored.
Yeah, it's got bacon.
Yeah.
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 So yeah, so it's incredible.
It's endorsed by the Prime Minister.
It's incredible. That was
you
good.
You guys don't know what that is, but
that
yeah.
was really good. I don't think anyone's gonna do better than that. Let's just get an extreme zoom.
Right.
There it is. Look.
You can be found in all your local retailers now, just $4.99.
That's a great deal. Thank you, James. We'll take a couple of questions before you shoot.
Of course.
Here we go.
Let's see what the beautiful fans of All Access have to say.
What do they know? James, give us your best Joker impression.
So it's bad because my better Joker impression was actually the Heath Ledger Joker.
Okay, you know, well, that's fine. You can
he's
be
like, that's so serious. Is it the scars? Want to know how I got them? It goes on and on from there. You know,
I'm kind of a Harley Quinn in some ways.
You are. You do kind of look like Jenna, actually.
If something happened with Jenna, you know where to go, right?
You can tag in.
Yeah.
All right, good to know.
I'll be there on the
thicket. I hope you know the waltz. Hope you know a Viennese waltz.
That would be bad. That would be bad for us. We'll take one more question, then you're out of here.
What were the early cars you learned to race in like? How fast did they go? It's a great question. I mean, the kind of entry level of car racing is a series called Formula 1600, 1.6 liter engine, about 140 horsepower. They only probably did 130 miles an hour, nothing too crazy, but a really good learning tool. And you kind of build up from it. It's like anything. You start kind of slow when you sort of build your way up as you move up the ladder.
All right. Well, look, great questions, guys. James has got to take off. He is getting cold downstairs. Thank you so much for coming up, brother.
I got this dancing thing to do.
You're going to kill it.
Always a pleasure, man.
And thank you so much.
Or woman or lady.
Yeah, just
I'm not sure.
Call me, man, boy.
I like these.
Thank you.
All right. Take care.
All right. Thanks, James. And let me tell you, James's dance, which of course came from Sharna's Creative, is incredible, and it's coming up. They are last to dance, so they put them there for a reason. It's going to be interesting to see, perhaps, could they get the top score. And we are so happy to have these two up here together again. Look at this. It's unbelievable. The two of you together, it is a sight for sore eyes, looking fabulous. I don't know how we're going to do this, Sharna, but let's just try and... There we go. Can we just kind of... I don't want to mess up your hair because you look fabulous.
Oh,
no.
This is an
just
issue.
Go down like that. Yeah, there you go. And then just kind of, we go. It's all right.
You're going to have to hold it.
Yes, I've done that. I've worn a lot of hats, I think, on this season. So I've had to do that a lot.
It's look. And,
I'm leaving
and,
this one off.
And the beard's almost growing back.
It's almost there.
Life is good.
I'm pretty excited.
We saw some emotional footage before of how your week's been. I don't want to get too far into it, but how good is it to be sitting next to her right now and just for the team to be back?
Come on. I mean, it's great. It's the best. You know, it was tough. I got to give Sharna so much credit because, you know, the decision ended up kind of being hers. And I know how badly she wants to come back. She knows how badly I want her back. But I want her back for the course. You know, I want to finish this competition with her, not just get through tonight with her. And she made a very difficult decision to sit tonight out to make sure that for the next 2 weeks, hopefully we'll be there. Please, guys, vote. And try and finish this thing together.
And you talk about a difficult decision, Sharna. Just bring us in because we could see the emotion and how difficult it was for you to actually make that call because you are a competitor and this is what you do. You love this. So how hard was it to not be there for James in that way tonight?
It was, I think, one of the hardest decisions I've had to make on Dancing with the Stars. I knew just by the feeling that I needed just a few more days, but in loving every single moment that I get to spend with James and dance with him and every single week that I get to go out there and do it and not wanting to miss out on a single bit of it, it was really hard for me to walk away from that. But I had to, like James said, I had to think the longest term. I want to be here for the end. You know, I have an epic freestyle planned. But I just want to keep enjoying every single moment with James. And if that meant missing this one, then that's okay because there's still two more left.
Yeah, and look, never has there been a more important time for you guys to vote because what happens now decides who makes it through to the final. So you've got to pick up the phone and just support one. I mean, James has never done this dancing thing before, but then he's got a to change partners.
Right.
I mean, he deserves a little bit of love for that. Come on.
I got a switch lot up. Of love. I got to switch up 2 weeks, and then no one else did.
Switch up week forced on you completely.
Yeah, exactly.
And yeah. I honestly, I have to say, as the judges said, huge props to James to be able to do that. There's not everyone could be able to do that. Switch up week is usually a disaster for most people. And you've crushed it both times. And I thank Jen for being an amazing team member for me and as well for James, because she's really helped me the last 2 weeks in being my body and taking all my instructions and bossing her around. I get bossy sometimes.
Well, look, James, as far as, look, we've got Derek off. It's just a regular party up here at All Access.
Hey,
it's all happening.
I know you.
The Grand Wizard. The Grand Wizard.
For you, James, bring us really into that as far as how nervous did that make you when you at first, you kind of, it's a security blanket with Sharna. She's been with you from the start and kind of almost like baby steps you into this thing. And then you got to kind of roll out. It's like, oh, now that you've kind of done it for 2 weeks, bring us into that honesty. I mean, how was it?
It's tough. It's really tough. You know, I joke, but it's serious in the sense that I say I've literally danced with one person my entire dancing career.
Yeah.
Only 2.5 months long. Yeah. But everything I've ever learned about dance came from her, came with her. And so stepping in with someone new, everybody's different. You know, we're trying to make analogies to racing. It's like jumping into a different race car. Everyone, they could be built the same, but they all feel a little differently and teach a bit differently, especially last week, not having Sharna in the room all week. And
yeah, it was tough.
It was tough.
Just on FaceTime.
Just on FaceTime, Skype, and things like that. But.
Okay, well, what do we know right now? If these guys get you there next week, are those feet going to be out there on that floor?
I don't know if I'm allowed to say it.
Ooh. The
crickets.
Yes. Don't say it then, but just do it with your face. Look, that looks like the smile. We don't want to give too much away right now, because that could be a big reveal next week. We cannot wait to see what you guys
got planned. So don't tell anyone.
Make sure that you vote, guys. Now it is so important to get these guys through to the final. Pick up the phone right now and vote. Thank you guys for coming up.
Thank you so much,
Thank
guys.
You.
Appreciate
James,
it.
James, amazing. Well, next week, the full beard's going to be back.
Yes.
Boom, by the finals, you're going to have a big, big, bad, big, bad boy.
No shave November.
Take Thank care. You, guys. You look fabulous, Sharna. You need to dance. You're looking lyric. You look awesome. Fabulous. So, yes, as I said, guys, so important to get these guys through to the final. Good to see you, man. And I want to say, wow, you and Sharna are back, and actually Sharna is back. We weren't sure if she was going to come up. She's got a crazy...
There she is.
But here she
there
is.
We go.
Look at this.
She's
she
really
made
back.
It. We got the bedazzled set saved for
of
you.
Course.
And where do we even start? A few of these little guys were floating around.
Very excited.
This is what we want to give you from All Access, one of these.
Yes,
the All
no,
Access.
Right? Yes, love
we,
it.
We hope amazing. That you guys will help get them into the final. And, of course, actually tonight you can get them the mirror ball if they make the final. So you got to vote, okay?
Please vote.
Yeah, we need those votes tonight, right? Yes, all of them. We need
all the votes.
You need all the votes, okay? They are very greedy with the votes. They want them all, and you need to give them to them. How good is it to be reunited? I know we saw that package. There was a lot of emotion. You know what it was? It was like, it's just this young lady gave me my confidence. Without her, I can't do this. I want to be there to the end with her. And now you're reunited. You're on the All Access set. I mean, could it get any better?
Reunited and it feels so good.
Yeah,
the song lyrics are very true. No, I mean, it sucked. It sucked so bad not having her there, you know. And even though she was still there and still part of it, It was different, and it wasn't the same, and I miss having her there. So the fact that we got to get back together on the dance floor and, you know, hopefully take this one
and
step further.
And then you up a notch, Sharna, and you just go and blindfold yourself? I mean, can we get an explosion?
In hindsight, it was very ambitious.
Yes. I don't think the doctor approved that one.
I felt for James because it was like, okay, there's a lot of confidence she's putting in you, and you really delivered. But that decision, how did it come to you? Were you just like, I'm back, but I want to – let's up the ante a little bit.
I looked at some of the Argentine tangos we've seen this season and they were phenomenal. And I was like, okay, how are we going to step it up from that? The lifts that Calvin and Lindsay do, the intricacies that Val and Laurie did, I was like, okay, so what can we do? What's James's strength? Leading me and moving me around the floor. And I don't think anyone understands how much of that he really does because it's so subtle. So I thought, all right, let's show him. Let's make it so obvious that you can't deny that he's leading me around that floor. I don't lead him. He leads me.
Well, it looked absolutely amazing. And all I can say, Sharna sat up here and she said, I'm not telling you about what we're going to do in Halloween because it's going to be pretty special. What I want to see is what she's planning for the freestyle, okay?
Oh, I'm definitely not telling
you
about that.
And I need you to help me here and to make it happen because... James, can you give us anything? I mean, can you give us a tease?
You know how this works, man. I do what I'm told. And
but
I've
told you the idea, right?
Oh, yeah, I know the
I'm
idea.
I'm imagining there's a word creativity is going to be involved, and it's going to be...
The word epic, I think, is involved. Yes. It's going to be very, very cool, very moving. It's going to be a beautiful piece.
Yeah.
Well, look, it's been incredible to have you back here. We kind of looked at tonight and sort of said maybe this was you being... Ricardo, but it comes together, and that's just you now. You know what I mean? Look at that guy. Remember him?
Oh, my God.
That confidence now is just James, isn't it now?
Yes. Yeah. No, luckily, Ricardo could be retired, and, you know, she's got me to the point where I can do that.
Have you seen those beer ads, and it's like, I am the most interesting man of the world? We think you're the most interesting man in the ballroom. You're like, cue the music.
I don't know about that.
Cue the music.
Oh, here we go.
And just read these for me, James. Look.
All right.
Come on, baby. Give me some volume on that. Come on.
Okay. I will leave the house with 5% phone battery and not bring a charger.
Woohoo!
I currently hold 167 patents, including the patent for having patents.
Whoa, damn!
I was once elected class president of a school I didn't go to.
Wow!
The square root of 69 is James.
Holy moly!
These are good.
Yeah. These are really
good.
Might steal
some of those.
That's it. You can use them, baby. Look, you really are
69 is James.
The most interesting man in the ballroom. And I want to say, how did we... There's going to be a car later on. Is that actually something that you've driven, or is it a prop? Or
that is an actual race car. That is a former Indy car that I drove in. And
wow.
It's actually the car that I had my accident in.
What?
Yeah, that car was damaged beyond repair. It wasn't safe to be back on a racetrack, so we just turned it into a show car. And that's the actual chassis that we have here at the show today.
Well, there you go, guys. I mean, I think that's finding out before everyone that's watching the show on ABC, man. Wow, that's amazing. And I know that all week long we've said fire questions. And, of course, because Sharna's back, there's been some crazy amount of questions. So we're just going to try and fire through as many of these as we can. Will you start an acting in Korea? I mean, you could do it. You could really
get it, right?
She keeps saying it.
If the opportunity came along, would you take it, James?
I would certainly give it a try.
Come on.
All right. It could be fun. Based on my experience here, I could see it being fun.
You'd be amazing at it. All right, here we go. Look, James, what's your favorite outfit that Sharna has worn?
Honestly, I think in a lot of ways, in week 5, most memorable year, our tango was awesome.
Yeah.
And I think the outfit that you had and with the crystals all up the side of your face and
your
hair.
Your silver suit.
That was pretty phenomenal. Your quick step one, the whole look with the hair, the
Jessica Rabbit.
She's had so many, it's tough.
So good.
You looked amazing in that, too.
It's tough.
They are the unsung hero. Incredible wardrobe and makeup department.
Absolutely.
I mean, wow. Without these guys, they add so much value. Let's do a couple more. James, there we go. It's true. He is in the ballroom. He's actually going to be coming up here later on.
Elio,
we're going to be
present.
Showing him the footage of his partner saying that you're the best dancer ever.
I don't think that's a good idea.
I don't think it went down well.
I'm not sure we should do that.
Hopefully we'll show you that next week. It should be fun.
Last
question before you guys take off. What is the pet peeve? I mean, I don't think you guys have got one, have you?
I honestly don't think so. Right?
I'm not just saying that. I don't think there's anything that you do that drives me nuts, and I don't think...
Changing the routine, maybe? Sometimes?
No, I'm just over that. It doesn't even drive me nuts anymore, because it's always better.
Yeah.
You know, like, it scared the crap out of me the first couple of weeks.
There's nothing that you do that is my pet peeve. Nothing that you do that bothers me or annoys
me. You don't drive slow in the left lane.
I don't drive slow at all.
You don't drive slow at all. I took her go-karting the other day.
Yeah.
She's actually pretty good.
That's what we heard. The trainer was teaching the master.
And then he had to follow me on the freeway somewhere, and then he was like, well, that was fun.
Now I get it. Now I understand why she was so good in the go-kart.
That's it, man. And that's
Lady
why
Ledford
you guys,
over here.
That's why you guys are such a great team. And look, she's obviously got a lot of confidence in you being so creative. You guys have got to help them get through so we can see this freestyle. We're going to let you guys go and work on your second dance. I really do appreciate you coming up.
Of course. Thank you so much. Always a pleasure.
Thank you, guys.
Look at this,
Thanks for coming back.
What
is the square root of 69, Sharna?
James.
Woo! There it is. Explosion.
Bye, guys.
There you go. Unbelievable when we go from one star to another. Unbelievable, first of all, that you made it this far. After 11 weeks, there you are. You are one step away from this freestyle, which we've been hearing so much about.
Really?
Sash. Well, Sharna, all the way through, you know, you wanted to get to this point. How do you feel right now about the first dance?
I mean, you know, obviously, the dance was a lot of fun. She did such a great job creating a fun story, something that everybody could enjoy. And
for sure I'm bummed I had a bit of a misstep. You know, we've never ever thought about scores. You know, that's one thing that we've stayed true to from the beginning of this competition. And it's not about the scores for me. It's about, I feel like I kind of let her down a little bit. You know, she puts in so much effort to make these beautiful pieces, and I don't want perfect scores for the scores. I just want to do my best for her.
Well, look, she's like, no. Chana, tell him that he could never do that, right? Ever.
No, he could never let me down. Of everything that he's put into it this entire season, of how much he trusts me and the fact that I've done some of my favorite pieces this season with you, someone that doesn't have dance talent. Because you've trusted me and you've pushed yourself the entire way. And I can see the disappointment in your face about that step. Be as brave as you want, but I can see it. But I want you to know that I couldn't be more proud of you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And look, if we could weigh in as the All Access team, we couldn't be more proud of you either, man. After 11 weeks, who would have thought, right?
For sure.
Who would have thought that you'd be standing here one day away from potentially winning that mirror ball? And look, the freestyle, that's what everyone wants to talk about. Everyone wants to know what you guys have got planned. I've seen it. I'm not going to reveal anything. But, Sharna, where did this inspiration come from? Where did you – is this something that you've kind of been working on for a while or what?
I wanted to tell a part of James' story, but in a very different way. And I wanted it to come from him and use his words. And so that's what this piece is. And it's basically filling the blank for James from – you know, when he did die, when he did flatline, to that choice that he made to fight and how he came back. Because even his doctor says they can do everything in the world, but he made the choice. He fought that and he came back. And I wanted to show how beautiful that is and how strong he is and how incredible of a human being he is. And so that's what this piece is.
And so much of life is about up here and you know, having drive and having that passion to be able to do it. So I think that these guys are very inspired, I think, from what you do on the dance floor, but not just that, the man that you are, okay? We love having you up here at All Access. We've had a great journey. We've had some memories. We've had some fun.
Uh-oh.
I mean, look,
oh,
man.
Something's coming. Oh, we're just tell.
All the
I know
good times.
You.
Look at this,
oh, good,
man.
Yeah. Good old Ricardo.
So many journeys.
AJ.
And look, all these incredible things. You were quite the actor, okay? So, look, here's the thing that we do here on All Access. No matter what, everybody leaves with a mirror ball, okay?
Oh, there you go.
Hey!
Perfect.
And you're going to win this mirror ball, okay? You ready?
Yes.
This is for the best actor on season 23. Congratulations.
You
this
like
is your
me.
Opportunity.
You really like me.
What is your acceptance speech? Go, please, James.
You know, I just can't thank everybody who tunes into Dancing with the Stars online and obviously on TV. I can't thank my amazing partner, Sharna Burgess, enough for getting the dancer out of me and making me passionate about dance, teaching me to perform not only on my feet, but through my face and through the rest of my body. That is what this award is really all about. I thank you for all the support, for giving us the medium to do this,
of course,
and share our story, our journey together. This one's for us.
And Sharna, of course, you get one too. There you go.
Oh, there you go. Never mind. This one's for me.
Keep the music going. Come on, guys. Keep that music going. This is for you, the Jessica Rabbit and the Liberian in the same season award.
Oh, okay.
Perfect.
I'll take it.
Are you trying to give people a heart attack?
She's trying to make people read again.
That's not the intention.
It's a good technique. I tell you what. And we've got that music going. It's that slow jam, man. So I guess what I want to do right now, on behalf of all of us here at All Access,
yes,
is I want to thank you, okay?
Oh,
I want to thank you.
All
right, here we go.
What is happening?
Get some rhythm going.
I want to thank you, James, for sending out the tweets every week. And thank you for coming up, even though you want to be dancing downstairs. Okay, hold on. We've got to just do the shout out to the main show.
Oh, wait. We've got to cut.
Yeah, okay. Don't worry. We're just getting warmed up. Oh, my goodness. Look at these guys. Incredible. Look. And then we're over here, guys, waving. Unbelievable, man. Unbelievable.
Mirror
Thank
balls.
You, Sash. I know where you were. You just disappeared. Now you're back, man. I love seeing you. And look, this is, of course, guys, if you didn't know, Sasha's got his own book, No Longer a Crab. It's incredible.
Yeah.
And look, that's available now at Barnes & Noble, so you got to check that out. But
amazing.
Look, as far as this experience, because we might not see you tomorrow, because you know how crazy it is with the Grove. We're calling it Grove Cella, because there are so many incredible things happening over there. You'll never forget your first Grove Cella. How, what has it meant to know that, you know, these people have been tuning in? Because this is like a select audience of super fans of the show.
Right.
They love, I want to tell you guys, you know, we get the most questions for you guys. And also for Sash, we get a lot of questions for you, Sash. Each week, they love you. So I guess, what do you want to say, and what's it meant for you to come up here to All Access?
I mean, just
be a part of our little show.
Obviously, thank you guys so much for the support. So much of why we're here is because of this beautiful woman sitting beside me. But it's also obviously your guys' support, and this is what we're here to do. We came here to dance and have fun. I think we did that, and I would love nothing more than to help this incredibly talented teacher, choreographer, dancer get her first mirror ball, and you guys can help with that. I'm doing what I can, but now we need everybody else to help out as well.
Well, yeah, you guys have got to support this freestyle. Is worth your votes. And look, you can look at right now. We're kind of seeing who's trending, who you guys are talking about. Look, wow. There's a lot of love out there for you guys.
Love it. Thank you so much, amazing. Guys.
Thank
so
you, guys.
Look, really appreciate it.
First of all, congratulations on winning your little mini dance ball, and this is incredible. I want to thank you for coming up each and every week. We hope to see you tomorrow, no matter what. You've done an incredible job. 11 weeks. Look where you are now, thanks to this young lady. So enjoy it.
Thank you so much, Jerry.
Enjoy it, man.
Appreciate it. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, guys. Pleasure, brother.
Always a pleasure.
And you got to do your part, as this man said right now. James says, you got to vote. This freestyle alone is worth your vote. It is an incredible, incredible performance that these guys are about to put in.